This is the following message broadcast by MMDA and local authorities. An explosion is taking place in the following locations: Taft Avenue in SM Mall of Asia. There are unconfirmed number of fatalities and injuries reported, but it is believed have hit over 100 or higher. The perpetrator's identity is unknown at this time. All persons living in Metro Manila are needed to take shelter in your home and do not travel, as more bombings may be expected to occur.
Ito ang sumusunod na mensahe na nai-broadcast ng MMDA at mga lokal na autoridad. Isang pagsabog ang nagaganap sa mga sumusunod na lokasyon, Taft Avenue at SM Mall of Asia. Mayroong hindi kumpirmadong bilang ng mga namatay at pinsala na naiulat, ngunit pinaniniwalaan na tumama sa higit sa 100 o mas mataas ang pagkakakilanlan ng mga salarin ay hindi alam sa ngayon. Ang lahat ng mga naninirahan sa Metro Manila ay kinakailangan upang sumilong sa iyong bahay at huwag maglakbay, dahil mas maraming mga pambobomba ang maaaring asahan na mangyari.
Including the Philippine government are still reminding many Filipinos that despite its Christmas rush, large mass gatherings, including Christmas parties, are banned in an effort to curb the spread of the coronavirus, although restaurants, shopping malls and other essential businesses will remain open but with safeguarded social distancing measures. The Philippine government issued warnings to those who violated the social distancing rules and says that severe penalties will be imposed. Meanwhile, the Philippine government via the NDRRMC has reported up to at least 24 people dead, with over 100 injured due to the bombings at EDSA Taft Avenue station and SM Mall of Asia. We still have no further information about the perpetrators yet, but we do fear that the number of deaths and injuries may continue to go higher due to the immense scale of this situation.
これは指定された場所または安全な場所に避難するように指示する緊急放送です。秋葉原で爆発が起こったばかりです。それはテロ行為であると信じられています。より多くの爆撃の脅威があるため、すべての居住者はあなたの安全のために安全な場所に避難するように促されます。現時点では加害者の身元は不明です。不審なアクティビティに気づいた場合は、 すぐに110をダイヤルしてください。 This message is transmitted at the request by the Vancouver Police Department and the Royal Canadian Mounted Police. Local officials have received reports that a massive explosion has been reported on the Highway 99 portion of the Lions Gate Bridge just between Vancouver and West Vancouver above the Bird Inlet. The explosion has caused the bridge to suffer a complete collapse of the middle section of the bridge. There were over several dozens of motorists that were on the bridge at this time. Any further information regarding the possible perpetrators of this event and the number of fatalities and injuries cannot be disclosed to the public at this time, but many speculate that this is clearly an act of terrorism. All residents in the city of Vancouver, including the district of West Vancouver, are strongly advised to seek shelter to a safe location or return to your homes, as more explosions may occur. The Highway 99 between Stanley Park and the Marine Drive interchange is being closed, and all motorists are redirected through the Trans-Canada Highway. Please remain calm and do not panic, as this will only make the situation far worse.
I'll be home for Christmas. You can count on me. These have snow and mistletoe and presents on the Christmas Eve will find where the love light be.
The following message is transmitted at the request by the San Francisco Police Department. At approximately 7:02 p.m., Pacific Standard Time, an explosion has just occurred in Mission Street in the district of the East Cut. Eyewitnesses via 911 calls said that a white van was seen deliberately crashing into steel barriers near the Salesforce Tower before exploding. The number of fatalities or injuries cannot be immediately known at this time. The threat risks for more explosions across the city of San Francisco is unknown at this time. Speculations from unknown sources claim that this explosion must be related to the bombings occurring in several countries, such as Canada, Japan, and the Philippines. However, that was not yet confirmed as of this moment. All residents within a 2-mile radius of the Salesforce Tower and Mission Street are urged to shelter in place now. To shelter in place, head to an underground shelter such as a basement, or in a centermost portion of your building with no doors and windows. Stay away from exterior walls, doors, and windows. Prepare an emergency supply of food, water, extra batteries, and a battery-powered radio for your stay. If out in a vehicle, and you are within 5 minutes of your destination, complete your journey. Otherwise, seek shelter in a nearby building where possible. Do not go outside your shelter unless it is deemed safe by the proper authorities. Stay tuned to this station or other media outlets for the latest information and updates on this dangerous situation.
Good morning to the citizens of Atlanta. My name is Betty McAllister, where I will give you the morning updates regarding the most horrifying and tragic incidents the whole world has never seen on such a scale. Somewhere at 7:02 p.m., Pacific Standard Time, a white van was reported by eyewitnesses to have deliberately run past the red light on 515 Mission Street in San Francisco and exploded just beside the entrance of the Salesforce Tower after ramming through cars and collided into the steel post bollard. According to local first responders, they stated that as several buildings, possibly within 800 feet, including the Salesforce and Millennium Towers, have suffered severe damage caused by a massive blast. Officials estimate the explosion at Mission Street to be equivalent as over 260,000 tons of TNT. Now we get to the number of casualties on the scene, as we are now getting updates right now. As many as over 32 people were killed and over 300 or more people may have been injured. 12 people were reported by hospitals to be in critical condition. We still have no idea about the identification of the driver who drove the van straight to the Salesforce Tower before the explosion, but we will get to that as expert investigators are on their way to the site. Now we go on live to one of our top reporters named Danny Hemwick, who was on the scene near the explosion, and he was just about to cover the story up close and to give us the information that he told us that he will be gathering. Hello, Danny?
Yes, Ms. McAllister. I am here near the intersection of First Street, where I could see that there are a lot of debris being strewn from several hundreds of feet across. The Salesforce Tower has suffered severe damage, as I could tell that the blast must have destroyed the front entrance facade. The steel bollards seem to have prevented the van from traveling further towards the tower, or even driving straight inside the building. Had it not have been there, there would have been more people dead. Or worse, the Salesforce Tower would have even collapsed, which might cause colossal damage to surrounding areas, and could also result in a complete collapse of the adjacent Millennium Tower and many other high-rises nearby.
I am glad to hear that, although I feared so much when you said that if the bollards weren't there. Anyway, what is the update on the situation and do we have any information regarding the perpetrator?
Ms. McAllister, as much as I could tell, I'll say that we can only get similarities from other cases across the world, according to several unverified sources. I suggested that this could be worse.
What do you mean by that?
Sources say that there are similar events happening all within a period of time. The first incident was reported back in December 24th when a suicide bombing has occurred in the Philippines. One was in a MRT Line 3 terminal station near Taft Avenue, and the other at the bus stop at SM Mall of Asia. Then, at that same day, an explosion, according to initial investigators that a suicide bomber was seen exploding on a crossing in Akihabara district in Tokyo. Many news sources say that this was the first terrorist bombing in Tokyo since World War II. And finally, the bombing of the Lions Gate Bridge in Vancouver just yesterday during rush hour. Betty, this could mean that what we're experiencing is not the first, but among a series of bombings across the Pacific Ocean, except this is Pacific Rim that I am talking about. We're talking about the bombings across the Pacific Rim.
Oh my God, if that is the case, then do we have information if the terrorists might strike again, or how did these terrorists travel around the world, and how can we prevent that? Why would the terrorists do this during Christmas, and what motive?
I wish I had more information about the perpetrators, but as far as I know, it might take some time for the investigators to find out where or when the terrorists might strike, judging how chaotic this situation had caused for those across the world. But all I could say is that the whole world is on their edge and they are all trying to figure it out for themselves. And to answer the last question, Betty, there are rumors or suspicions coming from the Philippines news media that one terrorist group named the Islamic State of Iraq and the Levant might be responsible, and the possible motive was that it was a result of their failure during the Battle of Marawi in Mindanao, Philippines since 2017, and their territorial losses from Iraq and Syria in 2019. These might be the possible motives, but as always, we cannot confirm that unless we get confirmation from the federal authorities.
That is one such horrifying event, and even it happened on Christmas Day. But how they were planning the bombings, we still don't know, but that information you've given us might be crucial. However, no group is claiming responsibility as of yet, but the ISIL is the only possible primary suspect for now, as this was designated a terrorist organization in our country and much around the world since long ago.
Please stand by for the following message. Please stand by for the following message. Please stand by for the following message. This is the BBC in London. There was an ongoing terrorist attack occurring in this country. At approximately 1:12 p.m., reports are coming into police that two individuals were seen shooting at pedestrians at the A100 road portion of the Tower Bridge using what believed to be a fully automatic submachine gun as described by eyewitnesses. These two individuals had drove the van recklessly through vehicles before they stopped at Tower Hill Memorial and began proceeding to stab or shoot any victims they see. Police are currently responding to this situation. All residents in London are urged to seek shelter or stay in your home for your own safety. Do not go outside unless it is safe by the proper authorities. There are many speculations being brought up almost immediately after this event had took place that this must be related to the bombings in the Philippines, Japan, Canada, and the United States, and this led to fears that the killers must be armed with high-powered explosives, which could cause massive damage and casualties. These theories could not be proven by the authorities at this time. Again, no one is allowed to go outside for your own safety. Tower Bridge will be closed to all traffic except for local and military personnel.
نحن دولة العراق الإسلامية والشام، المنظمة التي كنت تعتقد أننا هزمناها. أعلنا مسؤولية عن التفجيرات عبر المحيط الهادئ، الفلبين واليابان وكندا والولايات المتحدة الأمريكية. شيء تعتقد أننا لسنا قادرين عليه، ولكن بعد هزيمتنا في ماروي قبل 3 سنوات، ولأنك أخذت أراضينا من العراق وسوريا، لقد تعهدت بالتأكد من أن الأمريكيين والحلفاء لن يفلتوا من ذلك. إخواني وأولئك الذين عملوا كعميل مزدوج في بلدكم لديهم الكثير من المعلومات حول هذه العملية لعدة أشهر قبل هذا الهجوم. اعرفوا الآن أيهما وأين يجب أن يضرب أولا، وهؤلاء الأسيويون في اليابان والفلبين سيموتون أولا بسبب جهودهم المساهمة التي تهدد بتقويض إيماننا. ليس لدي أي تعليق على قول المزيد، لكنني سأخبرك فقط أنه لا يمكنك هزيمتنا أبدا، وسنتأكد من ذلك. الله أكبر، الله أكبر، الله أكبر.